Hello everybody, I'm in Storm here, and welcome back to Hearts of Iron 4. In the last episode, we began our assault on the British Raj down here in India, Pakistan, Burma area. Now, we were initially trying to come in from the north up here, but the mountainous terrain, the poor supply, and a bunch of other issues just made it pretty much impossible to come in through this direction. So what we did was we changed our strategy. We swung our guys back over here, and then we got our fleet involved to protect this region of the Indian Ocean and the Persian Gulf, and we launched a naval invasion to land here at Karachi, and we are now expanding from our beachhead. We want to take Ahmedabad and to get that port, and then we're going to push deeper into the interior of the country with the goal of sweeping over here and coming in on the flank of this British army and destroying it, because that is going to help with the next phase, which is going to be the invasion of the British Islands. Hopefully we will have a good fleet. I mean, our fleet is not bad right now. We got two carriers, we have two battleships, a whole bunch of cruisers, and a lot of destroyers. I mean, this fleet could put up a fight. I mean, it can't take on the entire Royal Navy by itself, but it can make a good accounting for itself. Now, I think somebody actually wanted me to take a look at some of the kill histories here on my fleet, actually. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Actually, the Elas got a kill on the NMS Vice Admiral Rosca, a Romanian destroyer. That's cool. The Kilikis, or the Kilkis, managed to sink three Soviet ships, a destroyer and two light cruisers. I'm not even going to attempt to pronounce those. The Georgios Avrov, which is actually the rebuilt cruiser, because the original one got sunk, doesn't have any kills of its own, but assisted the sinking of the HMS Repulse and those three Soviet ships. I was looking for the ship that actually got the kill on the Hood, because we did sink the Hood. Oh, it's like the Minsk. But I couldn't find it. I could not find it. So I'm thinking that whatever ship actually sunk the Hood got sunk itself. The Comintern was sunk. This is a veteran ship. Look at the kills. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 kills. And a bunch of assists. Assist on the Repulse. I think actually some of my submarines also have some kills. The HMS Rodney was sunk by the Okeanos. See, this got an assist on the Hood. This got an assist on the Rodney. Yep. So yeah, our fleet has been doing some damage. Oh no, we don't do that. All right, so let's go ahead and unpause. Let's get things moving here. We want to get this taken care of here. Unfulfilled import requests. What are we short on resources? We're short on steel. I guess we will get some from the German Reich. I'm gonna make sure that we keep this building. Oh, there's got a new military factory. What do we need? Infantry equipment. Well, we've got a nice stockpile of infantry equipment. We need motorized. So let's throw this in the motorized. Where's motorized? There it is. Okay. And actually, we have some army experience. So one thing I wanted to do here is go into my improved artillery. See, I installed a mod that allows us to create variants of everything instead of just vehicles. You know, tanks and planes and ships. So I'm going to go ahead and create a variant of my artillery. I'm going to crank up the reliability on that. Let's see, what does a barrel do? Breakthrough, defense, AP shells. Do you want to increase the hard attack on our... Or do you want to increase the soft attack? I think we want to increase the hard attack and the soft attack and crank up the barrel a little bit. So, go ahead and do that. Then we'll switch that over. Start building the new and improved artillery pieces with better shells and an improved barrel. Can you guys just, like, march? Come on, go. Actually, let me take this guy and say, get aggressive. Just push, fast as possible. And you just roll. Ah, they've got some stuff in there. Hold up. You guys just move out. Have them move in there. Wait, this guy's in position. No, no, you stay there. You stay. Attack. Oh, he's got a free dockyard. The German Reich has called Sweden as our ally in the German-Romanian War. Our war, the German-Romanian War, has been merged with the British-Swedish War. Sweden joined Axis. The United Kingdom declare war on Sweden. That's interesting move. Let's increase the speed and construction of our light cruisers. Free military factories. Again, we're going to put this in the motorized. We have a new national focus we need to select. Let's go the advanced training. Alright. Okay, we've taken a Madabad. That'll get us access to another naval base, which would help my supply throughput in the region, I hope. There we go. Alright, you... Just do that, mop up all that territory. We got some more factories out of that. We got four more factories. Let's throw them in there. Okay, we're gonna change up the battle plan a little bit. I'm gonna tell them to push a wide swath like that and execute aggressive maneuvers. We are continuing to take more factories. And what does the supply look like right now? Still kind of sketchy here. They went out of 20. Unread. Oh, managed to sink a convoy. That's good. Do we have any airfields yet? No, I did not see. Oh, there's one right there. Oh, we just finished research on Marines. Actually, what I'm probably going to want to do. Oh, it's 1942. Infantry anti-tank. That sounds nice. Like the sound of that. Oh, good. We have somebody moving in there. Not sure how many aircraft that I can store there. But I'll take that airfield. Because I'm going to take these planes and move them over. Take 800 planes. Okay, so. Let's take my close air supports and my fighters. Move them over there. And put them over this region. Provide assistance if we have any enemy resistance, which we haven't really run into so far. Just a couple of divisions down here. Nope, you are not moving in. Oh, more free military factories. Oh, a whole bunch more military factories. Okay. Now, what else do we need? Towed any air and towed any tank. Support equipment. Support equipment. I think that's probably the more important thing to get right now. So let's start up another run of support equipment. Throw everything I've got into there. I want to link up with my front up here. Those guys should be moving back to the front lines. Yep, yeah, air superiority. Ah, battleship threes. Okay. Super heavy battleships. So we work on more naval tactics or try to unlock more classes. Let's go submarine threes. Continue working on that. So those guys are continuing to push. Why are you strategically redeploying? Like, over there? Really? We are starting to stretch this army a little bit thin. Have we... yes, we have. We have some new divisions. So let's go ahead and put them right over here. So far, no enemy fleets have come over here to try to contest us, which is good. We are short on rubber and steel. Now, where are the good resources in the British Raj? Over here. Steel. Steel. Ooh, we need free civilian factories. We don't really need oil, so I'm not going to worry about synthetic oil plants. Let's go with military factories. do that. We got some rubber down here and some rubber in Sri Lanka. Ooh, that'd be good to get. Okay, so those guys are coming down there to hop in there. Okay. Let's see, let's do this. Super heavy battleships. Because why not? It'll take us 16 years. Alright, some more of these. Let's go ahead and fill out. Fill out that run of support equipment. Alright, we have taken Delhi. Did that affect our... Nope, still British Raj is only at 40%. Okay, let's actually change this up. Let's say, let's change your goals. Push. Push something like this. Oh, we just got landing craft and some more military factories. New research. Air land battle, shock and awe. Concentrated fire plans. Armies, heart attack plus 10%. Army soft attack plus 10%. We have to make a decision. Do we want to go with reconnaissance? Shock and awe. Enables tactic breakthrough. Combined arms. Air land battle. Let's go down the shock and awe. I like that. And so far, we have nothing resisting our push to the British Raj. So far, so good. And nothing in northern France. The British haven't tried another invasion yet after we threw that... their first attempt back into the sea. Alright, so let's... just whatever dockyards are going to throw into that super heavy battleship. So I'd like to get at least one or two of those. Alright, so this is what? 10 points... 1 point. 1 point. And actually, if I could do this. Just push in there. We're gonna split this front. Which is going to cut these guys off. Now, we'll open it up and these guys will probably flood in here, which might cause a supply problem, but that's alright. It actually looks like they're starting to attack already. What's this? I'm just seeing some convoys down here. In there. All right. So now we've gotten those guys cut off. Now this entire army I'm going to assign to this front. Then I'm going to grab these guys and assign them to that front. And we're going to readjust that to there. We're going to readjust this to here. Oh, no. Now, it looks like we've still got some British troops stuck in here, but as long as they don't move, they're okay. Now, do we need to bring these guys forward at all? Northern India. The fall of Oslo. For not the first time, Sweden has overwhelmed the defenders of Norway and put them under the boot once more. Oslo has fallen to the Swedish invaders. Forces of the Swedish army have taken Oslo from its Norwegian defenders. Although defenses were strong on the roads across eastern Norway, Oslo was left relatively defenseless as the Norwegians evacuated the city in the face of mounting Swedish invasion. Although the royal family has escaped, the country is rapidly falling to the Swedish advance. Now, are they actually? Indeed, they are. Sweden is just obliterating Norway right now. Actually, if we could bring Finland in. Well, I'm not entirely happy about Sweden joining the Axis. Because they were one of the, like, non-aligned states that I was kind of looking at absorbing after our war with the Allies is done. But, oh well. More military factories. What are we looking at that we need? Everything. Okay, so let's just start filling stuff out. Medium tanks. Medium anti-air. Medium tank destroyers. Can, you know, we just walk in, please? Ah, improved fighters. Let's grab improved naval bombers. And let's swap out our production line for fighters to the new fighters. Go with Toad anti-air. Ah, just finished advanced training. Do we want to go with artillery support? Let's do that. Looks like they got a lot of defenses there in Bombay. So, what we're going to want to do is Fall of Oslo. Let's see. Oh, they shifted control of Oslo over to Germany, which created another Fall of Oslo event. Okay. I'm like, wait a minute, we just have that? Alright. So, let's get some more naval dockyards building. No, we don't need expeditionary forces from Italy. More free dockyards. I at least want to get... Oh, we need steel. Rubber imports from Japan are not being fulfilled. Well, that's unfortunate. Can we import the rubber from the German Reich? And we're gonna need some more steel. 61 steel. We need to get our hands on this steel. Let's go grab it from the US. You guys send us some steel? There we go. Actually, that's really interesting, is that Japan has actually not declared war on the United States. And in fact, they're not even working on the focus to get the war goal against Japan, or against the United States. So it looks like whatever those sanity checks are that they implemented appear to be working. Because we are in ahistorical, so I guess a Japan that, you know, is embroiled in the middle of a major war isn't going to risk going to war with the United States. Because they're not really doing too well against the British here. But hopefully as my front creeps across here, we're going to be able to come in there and help them out. Guys moving in there, and then these guys are all gonna get overrun. Yep, there we go. Sunk some more stuff. Alright, so now we've cleaned that up. Let's get everybody back on this front. Have you taken Bombay yet? Yes, we have. Or rather, we've won the Battle of Bombay, and we are moving our troops in, and then there's going to be a British Raj fleet that's going to come out of Bombay straight into my carriers. There they are. And there I am. 5 light cruisers and 9 destroyers. Battle end. They retreat. Oh, there are more military factories. Medium self-propelled artillery. There we go. Alright, what's the British Raj at now? They're at 62%. Well, where are the rest of their victory points? There's one, one, one. Calcutta is 5. Dhaka is 1. Rangoon. Alright, well, we're going to adjust the plan again. Tell them to push. All the way here. Because frankly, we need... We need the resources. The steel, specifically. We're still short steel. Here's my fleet again. Come up against those cruisers and destroyers. Yep, they keep escaping. I don't think they made it. Nope, those are just transports. Air wings with no mission. We have to improve the range on our bombers. Alright, these guys, let's move them forward to that airbase, and let's put them over. Oh, well, let's go there either. We don't have the range. We've really got to improve the range on our planes. Or just get better planes. Which I am working on. Alright, did we get any new divisions? Indeed we do. We have new divisions. Oh, you know what I completely forgot about? Was this guy down here. Alright. These guys. Alright, let's spread them out along here, and let's give them an order to push. Push like this. And execute that order as soon as they are in position. Ah, we have resistance. Right, okay. So, let's push out some garrison units. We want to make a new army. Actually, let's go over to this theater. Make a new army. Not what I wanted to do. Okay, hold on. I gotta fix this. These guys are all working on this area. I think they gotta work on this area because this is all occupied. This area is all occupied. This area is all occupied. Yeah, that should do it. Alright, so what I actually wanted to do, and you guys are this color. There we go. Okay, so what I actually wanted to do was select these guys and make them a new army. Make them, I don't know, some sort of gray color. And then I want to send those guys to garrison. This region, which they aren't going to have enough forces to do, but at least get them moving in that direction. Because we're starting to take some infrastructural damage, and I need more military factories. What's this? That's Just convoys. Alright, so we're rolling pretty good here. What happened to the British Army? Did they evacuate? Oh no, they've come over here to resist me. I see. So I wanted to click on this. Supplies are good. Nope, new naval bombers. Very good. We're going to go work on some close air supports. Get 2.4 years. Actually, I'm not going to worry about the steel right now because we're about to take some territory that actually has steel in it. So, now this is the Japanese's chance because we have weakened the Allied defense. So they should be able to push. Oh, come on, guys. Sink those ships. Got logistics company, and for that I actually want to get over here and start working on some of this improved artillery, more dockyards. I'd like to get that down to less than a year to build up those battleships. Alright, so this is going well. We have any new... we actually have a medium armor. The first of our medium armor divisions has come out. Good. We should actually be getting another one out soon. And what I actually want to do is I'm going to do this. I'm going to put them into this army, and I'm going to grab one of the light armor divisions, and I'm going to shift that over to that division. So I want this army to have the medium armor in it. Yep. They cannot resist me. Alright. 1943. What are we going for? Infantry anti-tank. Let's go with night vision. Now, what are we going to do with these guys? The paratroopers. Because they're still up there. Let's actually bring them down here. We'll decide what we're going to do with them later. Now, what about those garrisons? Can we push them out anymore? No. We need to wait till they get trained a little bit. Alright. Any change in the progress? 73% towards capitulation. Now, actually, something I want to look at. Let's see. The German Reich's at 47%. We're at 31% participation. Italy's at 14%. What I would really like to do is get above Germany's participation in this war. What is getting Germany the majority of their participation, though? Occupation. 351 casualties. They've lost 1.75 million men in this war. 4903. Yeah, we just don't have enough occupation yet. More casualties. We've lost 803,000 troops. Let's see, United Kingdom has lost 1.57 million. France lost 1.63 million. The British Raj is down 526,000. Anybody else have any big numbers? Oh, a lot of these guys. Half a million there, half a million there. Alright, we're actually hitting the 40-minute mark on this episode. So we're gonna go ahead and end it here. See if we can push across here. I wanna get this. Oh, we got the United States is justifying a war goal against us? Oh no. I do not want that. Unknown focus. Okay, well that's going to change the complexion of the war if the United States joins. I was hoping they were going to stay out of it. I was definitely hoping they were going to stay out of it. Because if the United States joins the war, then we will have to beat them in order to beat the Allies. Which is unfortunate, because I was hoping we would just be able to knock down the British Isles, and that would be it. But now we'll have to do an invasion of North America. Oh well. And hopefully they don't cause major problems along some of these fronts. Alright, well, we'll go ahead. We're going to end it here. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Go ahead, like, subscribe, and comment. And I will see you next time.